My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, the Second Vatican Council emphasizes a twofold task, the 40-day Lent in preparation for Easter. First, preparation for baptism or renewal of the baptismal promises. Second, penance. SC 109. Easter is actually the feast of baptism, and all who are already baptized will be baptized in the Easter Vigil. Renew the baptismal promises and answer the questions: Do you renounce evil? Do you believe in God? So, Easter night will be a new beginning for each one of us. Everyone sees the light of the risen Christ. But what is penance? And what is fasting? And what they really mean? Fasting and repentance. We have the best answer from the Old Testament. Fasting means Prophet Isaiah chapter 58 verses 5 to 7 and 10. He says, "The fast that I chose, a day to humble oneself, is to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes. Will you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I chose? To loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke. Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your homes? When you see the naked, to cover them and not to hide yourself from your own king." There are many examples of fasting and penance in the scripture. The repentance before God, a prime example in the Old Testament, we can see. The people of Nineveh who repented truly by hearing the prophet's exhortation in the book of Jonah, chapter 3, verses 5 to 8 and 10. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk, and he cried out, 40 days more, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, and everyone, great and small, put on sackcloth. Let us look for an example of penance in the New Testament. And each one of us should ask a question. How did sinful people experience and encounter with Jesus Christ? There are many references in the New Testament. The people who really encountered Jesus Christ and changed their sinful life into holy life by their true repentance. An adulterous woman, a tax collector, and various people who listened to Jesus Christ and experienced a cure in their insight. And they experienced forgiveness. Repentance means insight and change. One should take a strong decision and believe and have strong faith in Jesus Christ to become a new and changed person. The true repentance will lead each one to experience the salvation. So, it is neither about self-flagellation nor about punishment, rather the acceptance of salvation, which is promise of God through Jesus Christ. All the people who repent and believe in the good news will be saved and will inherit the kingdom of God. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we are in the season of Lent, and we need to repent for our sins ask forgiveness from God. May God bless you all. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.